Hello, everybody. I want to thank you for clicking on this. I appreciate it. Clicking on this video. So the link to this spreadsheet is going to be in the website, GaryMcNeilyIT.com. It's going to be there. So you click on that. Just go to that link. It's going to be a link at the bottom here of this video for that. Anyway, so let's talk about this a little bit, shall we? I want to just kind of put it in perspective, the numbers, if you will, for how much somebody makes per hour. So $9 an hour. Usually, you know, what you're looking at, right? If you make any more than $30 an hour, you probably don't need my advice. Let's just put it there, right? So let's just put that. You make $30 an hour more. If you make $110 an hour, you don't need to know what I need. I can't teach you anything, right? You know, so you're pretty good if you make more than $30 an hour, let's just say. But if you make under $30 an hour, then this is the channel, this is the video for you. Okay, so let's go over this a little bit, right? Make $9, $10 an hour, $12, $15 an hour, right? Let's say you work at Walmart, McDonald's, Kmart, Amazon, something like that. Okay, and you want to know, like, how does this work? You know, how do I really figure out? First thing to know is how much you make. How much do you really make, right? That's really the answer, the question you need to answer, right? How much do I really make right now? Like, what exactly do I make? And then what do I want to make? You know, and you may be surprised to know that number, actually, right? You may have a number in your mind, like, I want to make, you know, $800 a month or something like that, or let's say a week. You know, if I made $800 a week, I'd be good. I'd be set, you know, and that's your number, right? Let's say that's your number. Okay, awesome. And this is just an Excel spreadsheet to just factor in, you know, plan out your bills, plan out what you want to make, okay? And let's go a little bit. Somebody makes $9 an hour. They work 160 hours a week. They usually gross $1,400. So 30% of that is $432, like taxes, let's say, right? Your net pay is $1,008. Maybe your mortgage, your rent, whatever, is $300. Your cell phone is $50. Your internet's $100. Your water, gas, bill, electric is $150. And then maybe miscellaneous bills, food, beverages, water, whatever, right? So you're left with like $800. Well, that's $800. And then you're left with like $200 is your like take home pay or your spending money. You know, you can just, okay, this is just expendable money, right? That's $200 a month. Up until say $15 an hour, your expendable money is $800, right? If you got those kind of bills. Okay. So hours per month is 672 hours in a month. Okay. That means you have 512 non-working hours. That means you sleep for probably 280 hours a week or a month. Sorry, a month. Is that a month? 70 times 10 times 4. Yeah, a month, 280 hours, which leaves you 232 hours to do whatever it is you want to do with whatever it is you want to do. Okay, you're not sleeping. You're not working. Okay, and I factored in 10 hours a day for sleeping, because there's maybe some commute time or there's other things, right, involved in that. So having said that, let's go over the course. Well, let's just go over the time frame, right? Let's say, right? So the course I made that I'm going to talk about in a minute took me 2 months to create, and I did it more than 2 hours a day, but let's say 2 hours a day. So all in all, I put in 120 hours of making a course that's like 20 hours long, right? Let's say. And for, you know, for anybody else, let's say anybody else spent on their craft. So the reason I did this course was so I could two things. One, I could teach other people how to do what I do. That's the first thing. The second thing is it's I see it as like a benefit for me, because I can learn and I can grow. And I can use it as for my next career. You know, I can say, well, I've created this course and I can dictate to the marketplace. The marketplace can tell me you're worth X. Okay, great. Thank you. And it's a way just for me to keep score, if you will, right? I want to keep score on this sometimes. And also I want to create a product, right? That's all I'm about. So I want to do that. So other folks, let's say you, whoever you are, right? Let's say you spend 1 hour a day training yourself for 1 week or 1 month, right? 1 month. What does it look like? Okay, 1 hour, 1 hour a week, or 1 hour a day times 1 month. What does that really look like? How many hours is that? Okay. 1 hour is nothing. That's nothing. That's 28 hours a month. You know, maybe 30, but let's say 28 hours in a month that you're just dedicating to whatever it is you want to do. Okay. So typically minds don't work that way. People's minds don't work that way. So what I've heard from other folks is this. What they tell me is they say, hey, Gary, I usually spend 6 hours on Saturday, 4 hours on Sunday, because Saturday is a lot easier. Or I spend 4 hours on Saturday, and then spend 6 hours on Sunday. And I spend 2 hours on Friday, and I spend usually no time on these other days. Okay? And they don't usually spend that much time on this. 2 hours, 4 and 6. That's what they're telling me. Okay, how much is that? Let's see. I've never actually factored in how much this hour, how many hours this is. 0000246. Okay, that's 48 hours a month that you know, some people I talk to or whatever, they spend on training themselves, you know. And so let's put that in perspective. Yeah, the month, that means in a month's time, you can be ready for a help desk job. So in a month's time, if you make $9 an hour at whatever you do now, in 1 month's time, you can make $15 an hour in 1 month, actually, right? You can be ready for that. Now, that's an online job, right? Okay, obviously, it's an online job. So look at the jump, right? So if right now you make $9 an hour, and after bills, it's like $200. In 1 month's time, in 48 hours, really, that's all it is, right? 48 hours. You could make $15 per hour, you know, which is $800 expendable money. That's all it is. I'm not talking about get rich quick, right? I'm not talking about, like, you know, go $0 to $1 million in 6 months with no work and all that stuff. It never works that way. Let me tell you, it never, never works that way. And these people who are like on YouTube and Instagram and all these other ones that are wealthy, let's say, right? I'm pretty sure what happens is even they have a full-time job, okay? They probably put in, I know what I do. Let me tell you what I do. Let's just put it there. I'm not going to talk about other people. Let's just tell you what I do, right? So me, myself, here's what I do, right? This is me, myself. And I'm nowhere near yet a millionaire. Let's just put it that way, right? So me, myself, every single day, I put at least 6 hours, okay, at least. And on these days, that's at least 10 hours, easy 10 hours every Sunday, easy. So just me, okay? Just me. This is just me. So that's 10 and 10. Now, this is not work. This is just me doing, like, regular non-work stuff, right? Let's be fair. I think it's more like 4. Let's be fair. I think it's more like 4. Let's be fair on that deal. I think it's more like 4 hours. Let's just assume. I think it's more like 4. It's not like 6. It's more like 4. Okay. That's 160 hours. A month I put in, right? The 10 hours a day is accurate, right? On Saturdays, that's 100% accurate. And I'm nowhere near, right? Compared to millionaire status, nowhere near, right? Now, what I usually do is I just like learn learn stuff, or I'll unlearn stuff, or play on the computer and just like figure out stuff, right? Trying to learn whatever, right? Dedicating something like that. I think my time could be more efficient. I think I could just like say, hey, I probably could just, if I was smart enough about it or I planned it better, I probably could just put 4 hours in every, you know, Saturday, Sunday, and that's it. That's all I need. If I was really focused, right? What I'm talking about, if what I do is I have like an idea, I want to do something, right? And I'll research, and I'll, okay, figure out some things, right, on how to do stuff on the computer or networking or backup or anything like that, just learning, right, watching YouTube videos and just doing stuff like that, maybe installing a lab or whatever, right? And I think if I was maybe more focused, that if I said, okay, I'm going to do 4 hours only, right, on this time, I'd probably be better off in that case, but I'm not. So I just do it. I just do it like this. So until I do it differently, you know, this is what I do. All right. So I do that. You know, it's not really focused. It's kind of focused. It's not really focused, right? As much as it should be. But I know. So that's probably the case, right? If you even took maybe just some of this time that I did it in, you know, in a month's time, like I said, you just have to do 28 hours, really. What did I say? Like, you know, 4 hours here, 4 hours here, four times, what is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4 times 8 is 32 hours. If you just did 32 hours a month in 1 month time, really that's it. You know, just 4 hours. Focus time, right? Because a lot of people are different than me. Maybe they're more focused. So you can go from $9 to $15 an hour. So what course are you talking about, Gary? You're just like, what course are you talking about? Well, I'm talking about this one right here. This is the course I was talking about, right? This is how I, this is the course I created. This is learn backup and restore with CommVault and get a high paying job. So you learn Windows, Server, Linux, Oracle, CommVault, VMware, Amazon, AWS, NetApp, and get a high paying IT job. So you don't need any computer skills. Now the get a high paying job, right? That's not like, that doesn't mean like you go and it's 21 hours. It doesn't mean, oh, I'm taking the course and I'm done. Doesn't work that way. Doesn't work that way. It is true. These are true. You don't need any skills to get this, to learn this. That is 100% true right there. Meaning you can know nothing. You just have to watch the video. Really, that's all it is. So I start you off with an introduction, and I start you with a CommVault lab. So it makes no sense for anyone to get into IT and you don't have a niche. And I talked about it last video. If you don't have a niche, and your niche is here, right? Friend, your niche is this. Niche down, right? And you walk into a job like you walk into a sysadmin job right now, right? Or let's just say help desk, right? You have to know Active Directory. That's really the standard, right? You have to know that. And lucky for you, I teach you how to do that. I teach you, you have to know Windows. So I teach you how to download and install VirtualBox, which is VMware, or not VMware, but it's VirtualBox. You install Windows VM. Then I teach you how to set up Windows Server, how to set up the IP address, how to install Active Directory, which is Active Directory is a way to manage servers and manage users. Then I take you through installing Ubuntu, which is a Linux distro, right? And then I take you through how to join it to the domain, meaning Windows Server. This one here is not really necessary, but it's, you know, you can watch it, right? Okay, then I take you through how to get CommVault and how to install it. Again, we're niching down, friend, right? Does you no good if you learn a bunch of skills, sysadmin and help desk and a bunch of skills, and like they're really wide, right? And your competition's a lot more. But if you niche in CommVault, oh, I know CommVault. Okay, good. Of course, you have to know the underlying stuff like the Windows side, but you don't know have to know everything about it. You just have to know what is dedicated or what applies to CommVault, okay? So then I take you through what do the buttons do. These are very long videos, let's say, right? I take you through how to create users in CommVault. I take you through how to create CommVault user groups, how to create client groups, how to set up Active Directory in CommVault and log in, how to install Windows Media Agent and a file agent, how to install Unix Media Agent and a file agent, how to set up a storage library. So what I do is I use OpenFiler for this. That's why I use OpenFiler. So OpenFiler is just open source file system, right? You have NetApp, you have EMC, Data Domain. And once you know one, if you know OpenFiler, you know them all because they all have to work the same way. And the little thing about that is companies like the Major League Baseball, the UFC, right? They use like Quantum, I think, is the product they use. They also use CommVault as well as their backup. But their storage they use is like NetApp, it's EMC Data Domain. I'm not Data Domain. Yeah, sorry, EMC Data Domain. It is EMC VNX. It is Quantum DXI storage. HP, what is it, 3PAR, HP 3PAR, some of that. Hitachi, you know, they use some of that as well. But you're learning the fundamentals, or not really the fundamentals, but you're learning, okay, what is this file system, right? So you get an idea, and you can basically apply that to your job, because you're going to have to know some aspects of it. How to install Active Directory, file agent. So I also show you how to install SQL. That's really key right there. So when you're in CommVault admin, you touch everything. You touch the network admin, the sysadmin, the firewall people, the IA people, like information assurance, the DBAs, you know who they are. They talk to you. They talk to you because you're backing up their databases, right? You're a really, really important person. I also teach you how to install Oracle. I believe this one is 12C, I think I installed on. So I teach you how to install Oracle. So you get all these skills, right? It's really nice. I teach you how to perform a backup and restore in CommVault. I teach you how to manage the CommServe with another computer. I teach you a little bit about deduplication. I teach you how to set up and restore CommVault using the Amazon AWS cloud. So think of this as another skill set really wrapped in this course is what it is. So it's a skill within a skill, right? So the good one, here's the good one, right? The view of the CommVault logs. So the CommVault logs are, you know, obviously I don't know everything there is to know about everything, but I know this much. CommVault logs are really critical when you come to troubleshooting. That's really the first place you go to, right? How to perform a disaster recovery on a CommServe. How to install VMware ESXi hosts. So you're going to get some VMware knowledge as well. So that means virtual machine, that's another skill set they have. How to set up LUNs and OpenFiler, we talked about that before. How to install NetApp. So NetApp it's a paid filer or file system, basically, right? A lot of companies use NetApp. So this is a skill within a skill. So CommVault, you're having an understanding of some of the how NetApp kind of works in this course. Okay, and then I take you through how to set up a VSA agent, which is nothing more than you're backing up virtual machines, because CommVault does both virtual machines and it backs up Windows file systems, and it also backs up Windows servers, Linux servers, physical boxes, and virtual machines. And then I give you a little bit of SharePoint. So I teach you how to install SharePoint. You know, SharePoint 2019. I teach you how to get a job. So this course, it does you no good if you don't know how to get a job. You're like, okay, I don't know. What am I do with this skill? Okay, I want you to get a job. I want you to come back and say, hey, Gary, really appreciate you teaching me. I got this course. It's fantastic. Thank you. I got a job. That's really the goal here, right? It's the goal. This is the goal, right? The cool thing about CommVault, it doesn't matter where you're from, doesn't matter where you live in the world. No, it doesn't matter, because CommVault is one of those skills that's, you know, transferable everywhere in the world, right? And then how much money can you expect in exchange for the value you provide? So, you know, nothing's for free, right, by the way. You have to give something. You have to give something to the marketplace in order for you to have money. So think of money as like certificates of appreciation. So you give value and you get these certificates of appreciation in return. And that's really what it's about. So again, there's nothing for free. So let's talk about this a little bit. So you may say, oh, well, that's a little kind of high with the money there. Wow, $94. They always have it. Usually they always have a special, right? Let's just be honest with that. Udemy always usually has a special. So the this will go from five hours, it'll go back to 94, right? And then it'll go back down to, 9 or 12 or whatever it is, right? Okay, yeah, I get that. So let's think about this, right? So the value of that, right? So usually, what is it like? $3,000 for a, let's not even go further than that. I think the cost of online tuition is like $500 for 3 hours, right? And you have to buy 3 hours. So $1,500 for a three-hour course, right? $1,500. Compare that to, let's say at full price, $94, $95, let's say, right? Okay. Yeah. That three-hour course, that's going to get you what? What's it going to get you? You need more than that. You need, for a degree, I think it's 120 hours, right? Something like that, right? So if you take 120 hours times $500, right? That's a lot. I don't know what that is, but that's a lot, right? That's a lot of money, okay? $500 per hour, and you need 120 hours to graduate, right? That's at least 50 grand. What is it? 120 times 5 was like 12 times 5 is 60. Okay, 60 grand. $60,000 is what it is. Okay, $60,000 for your course. Or I'm sorry, for your degree, right? Now, it's going to take you 4 years to get that, typically, right? Plus, you're also going to look at, the amount of time you put in. What you do now, you have a full-time job right now, right? Then you want to go to college. Where are you going to find the time? Or even you don't have a full-time job and you want to go to college. Okay, great. Well, in college, what do you usually do? Is it the same? Maybe it's the same. I don't know. So the same hours that you put in here in this graph here. So let's say in college, you put in 4 hours. Maybe it's online. So you put in 4 hours a day. And on Saturday and Sunday, you put 0 hours, let's say, right? Let's just say, right? So that's 80 hours a month you're putting in. 80 hours a month you're putting in. 80 times what? 80 times, I think you go to school, what? October, November, December, January, February, March, April, May, I think. What is it? Eight months, right? 8 months. That's 8 months, no? 8 months. So in 8 months' time, 8 times 8, so that's 640 hours you put in for 1 year of college, right? Just 1 year of college. And you do times two, right? 2,560 hours, I think it is, right? Something like that, of study time, right? Give or take, whatever. Just for this degree, right? Then then you start studying, right? Then you start getting a job, let's just say. So now you have that. So that $60,000 that you pay. Now, you haven't earned anything yet, by the way. Let's just say you have not earned anything yet, okay? You earned zero so far, okay? And that's 2,560 hours in 4 years' time just to have the privilege to pay some college $60,000, okay? Whoa, that's a lot, right? Okay, ouch, right? No money's coming in, zero money's coming in, okay? No money's coming in. So college is good, right? If you want to go to college, great. You need to go to college if you want to be a doctor or a lawyer or a accountant or something like that, I'm sure. But if you're not into the college thing, right? So why not give this a try? That's what I'm saying. So take that same mindset, because right now it's, what are we at? It's, you know, it'll be college soon, the season soon, right? And you having the ability just to have the foresight and think, hey, listen, I don't know if I'm going to do this whole 2,500 hours to get to pay some, you know, 2,500 hours just to have a degree when I can just take the same amount of effort and time and in 2 years' time, you know, in 1 year's time, actually, really. So realistically, right, realistically, in a month's time, you can make $15 an hour, and realistically, in the IT field, like help desk or whatever, realistically. If you take the same, if you take 8 hours, right, 80 hours, and you apply that, so just think of this, think of this, right? So in your first month, you put 80 hours in, okay, $15 an hour, right? So every month, you start building on it and building on it. In 6 months' time, 6 months or 8 months' time, let's say, in 8 months' time, you've spent 640 hours. Imagine what kind of knowledge you have at 640 hours, okay, of knowledge in the IT field. I'm here to tell you, friend, that if you spend 640 hours training yourself, right, easily you can make 60 grand, easily. I mean that, easily. You know, and then a year from now, I'm not kidding when I say this. A year from now, you can make 100K. I've seen it how many times? Seriously, I've seen it how many times? 100K in a year is very easy. Well, let me back that up, actually, right? 100K in a year is not easy. That's not easy, right? Nothing what I'm talking about is easy. Let's just put it out there. Everything I'm talking about is hard because you have to rethink. You have to change the way you think. You have to change your mind. You have to change your habits completely because IT demands of you, you know, it demands of you learning every single day. And we're not talking about programmers, right? That's a totally different thing. We're going to talk about that. That one is like, okay, I have no clue. I know a little bit, but I don't really have an idea of what really goes into that, right? Because when I watch some stuff like the Tech Lead or whatever, some of those channels, they're like, near them over my head, you know, glazed over eyes, no idea, right? And like, I have no idea, right? I have no idea, dude. So I just, okay, enough of that. I'm just talking about help desk. I'm talking about Windows and Linux stuff. That's it. You know, we're not talking like SQL, or not SQL, but Apache, PHP, front stack, full developer, or what is it, full stack developer. We're not talking about none of that stuff. We're not talking about Silicon Valley either, by the way. We're not talking about like $4,000 a month rent, all that. We're talking about you getting a job, making $15 an hour in 1 month's time, going from nine or whatever you're making now, okay, as a help desk admin. That's all we're talking about here. Simple stuff. Don't overthink it. Don't get too ahead of yourself, right? You know, oh, I want to get all this stuff. Well, just start with step one. You know, just get to start with step one. Let's do that first. You start with step one, you know, then see how it goes. You know, it's gonna challenge you. It's a lonely world, right? IT is a lonely world because there's going to be friends out there who are like, hey, dude, hey, girl, hey, man, hey, whoever. We're going to the beach. We're going out to the mall or something, right? You want to come? No, I can't. I got to study. Whoa, you got to study? What are you talking about? What are you studying for? You're not going to school. No, I'm studying. I want to get a better job in IT. Oh, well, you know, and who knows? They'll like, try to discourage you. We don't know, right? We don't know the people. But if you put that hard work in, you know, it's going to really pay off in a month's time. You're really going to see it. And, you know, the more, I know this is nothing in this, but, I mean, there's nothing to talk about in this video on this because I wrote the videos for it. But going in interviews, you do as many as possible. So having the 80 hours, let's say, right, you can go on an interview easily. You have enough knowledge to go on an interview at 80 hours. Yeah, believe that. You know, you're not probably going to get the first job. Nobody usually does, right? you have to keep applying, and you have to always look for a different, apply everywhere, right? And when you apply everywhere, write those places down. You know, maybe record the interview, write it down. What do they want me to know? I don't know. And then research. That's where this comes in to play. The whole research thing, where you research, help desk, you do my, you know, you, there's videos I have, right, about it, right? Again, I have the course, right? You do the course, you're good. So you do help desk, after you help desk, then jump directly into CommVault. Because once you're, you know, get the baseline knowledge, and then jump into CommVault. Full head in, right? Straight ahead, jumping into CommVault. The reason you do that is you're niche down, right? You're niche down. So I thank everybody. Thank you guys for, you know, watching this video. Please like and subscribe if you see it. It's down here, I think, somewhere. Please like and subscribe the channel. And have a great day.